So this is probably my favorite scene of the entire season of The Mandalorian. It's just so funny, entertaining, well-crafted, and, well, they hit the child. What up, everyone? It's Kirtan Singh, and I'm back with a review of the final episode of the first season of The Mandalorian, and it was amazing. Yes, it does have one or two flaws, but overall I think this episode is really well done. As I've said in the opening scene of this episode is my favorite episode. Yes, they hit the child and it really hurts when they did, but I really found that scene entertaining. It had such a good humor, and considering this was directed by Taika Waititi, the guy who did Thor Ragnarok and What We Do in the Shadows, this is such a good episode. So this episode concludes the first season by finalizing the child's arc, in a sense, with what's happening on Novara, I believe the planet's called. I can't recall exactly, but it is really well done. Moff Gideon is defeated, and we'll see later on at the end more what happens with him, but the way it goes about was really well done. I had a feeling that IG-11 would come and save the child, which he did. I didn't expect him to come straight to save the Mandalorian and everyone else, but he did, and it was so well done. The action was good, the action was so entertaining and really well executed. But what I don't get then is why they send the flametrooper in, and then the flametrooper's directly about to burn the child, and it's like, I get you can deal with him dead, because obviously we are aware from the last, third episode or something, that they were going to kill the child at first. But the thing is, I don't think, you know, his charred body, or her charred body, whatever it is, would be helpful to the Empire. I'm not exactly sure what they're going to do with it, but if it is the cloning process, which everyone suspects it is, I don't think a dead body would be all that useful either. As we know from the Clone Wars series, that after Jango Fett's death, creating clones was more difficult. So obviously, there's something with that you've got to work around. Who knows, maybe in the years since the Clone Wars, the way that you can clone something has changed. Maybe you can use a charred body, or even a dead body at that. When it comes to the execution of it, there's only one scene which felt really off to me. And that was after the Mandalorian uses the jetpack and defeats Moff Gideon. He lands and suddenly, well, the shock trooper, Dune, she's staying there. For some reason, I don't really know why, and they said it probably, but I just got lost, because I was like, wait, she's staying here? Why wouldn't she go back or go elsewhere with Mandalorian, maybe, or just on the run, because she doesn't want to deal with, you know, that kind of life anymore? Maybe she's back into it. I can't really know for sure, because maybe I missed it, but that was a little sudden to me. Otherwise, I enjoyed that ending and the way it said goodbye, as well as how it said goodbye to IG-11. A very poetic way to start the season, with him self-destructing and then end it with him actually self-destructing. And just like a video game, still the Mandalorian levels up even more and gets a jetpack, which is another payoff to episode 3, where he's like, I need to get me one of those. The one problem that I do have slightly is that he uses it way too easily. It's true that he had to use the grappling hook as well to get onto the ship, which was real nice, but which was real creative to see, but it still seems like he got better a bit too quickly. Nothing that really took me out of the episode itself, especially considering he was almost dead, but nonetheless, it didn't take me out of the episode itself. Him revealing his face to the droid made sense. I would have preferred not to see it. I forgot about this, I just remembered now, but Moff Gideon was shooting them with his TIE fighter, but if he actually killed the child, he could have just blown up the child if he hit it, or hit near it. So I really wonder what's the extent of the child, how much of the child they actually need for the Empire's, you know, need and desire, because we still don't know why the Empire wants it. We just know that they want it for God knows what. But overall, this episode was really well done. The ending itself, while I'm talking about Moff Gideon, was such a surprise. Him having the Darksaber was so cool. When I first saw that little blade pop out and he was cutting through it, I was like, oh, does he have a vibro blade or something? But no, he doesn't. He has the Darksaber, and it makes a lot of sense, since Moff Gideon was there when the purge of the Mandalorians happened. and like even the Mandalorian knows him and everything, and it's really cool and interesting. It makes sense that he would take the Darksaber to have control over Mandalore to symbolize his power over them, because that's what the Darksaber represents. And for those of you that are just watching the Mandalorian because of the child Baby Yoda, and because of, you know, just now getting interested in it, the Darksaber started off in the Clone Wars, and it was the first ever saber of a Mandalorian Jedi. And it is such a cool saber that has gone from the Clone Wars to Star Wars Rebels and now in the Mandalorian, which is so great to see. George Lucas, Jon Favreau, Dave Filoni all had such a big part in the Darksaber's journey, and I'm so glad to see it in the Mandalorian itself. So this episode and the season as a whole was so good. I would give this episode a solid 8 or 9 out of 10. Just I have a few problems which I've already stated, but otherwise it was really entertaining and it was of a decent length, which is some of the problems I've had with previous episodes. But overall the season, like I said, had some slow episodes, some boring episodes, and yes, they introduced one or two characters which were important and at times gave a little more backstory to the Mandalorian, not really the child, but there are still a lot of unanswered questions, and considering this is season one, I'm okay with that. But the problem is that the first three episodes were really good, then the middle chunk was a little hit and miss, and finally the last two to three episodes were also really good. So I'm gonna give this show a solid 8 out of 10 because it is the first season, and with a second season coming, there is the possibility that it can only improve and build upon what's already been set up. So let me know in the comment section down below what you thought of The Mandalorian. Do you really love it as much as the movies? Are you more interested in it because it's a TV show and less of the movies? Let me know down below. Make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, and until next time, I'll see you guys.